Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. If you are first time in this channel, please click subscribe and please click also the notification bell so that you will know if there is a new video in this channel. Today I am going to teach you how to create the electrical diagram, electrical circuit, especially for electrical system for ship. Now this is the diagram that I have created, which is for fuel oil supply pump and fuel oil booster pump. On board ship, you cannot run your main engine without fuel, as well as you cannot run your auxiliary engine or generator engine without the fuel. So here we have the system that will deliver fuel to the engine. So we have fuel oil supply pump 1 and fuel oil supply pump 2, and this is how you create a diagram. So we have in electrical diagram, we have power circuit and we have control circuit. So I created this diagram. So we have also panel board. So panel board for the fuel oil supply pump number 1 and panel board for the fuel oil supply pump number 2. So this tutorial is going to be a sequence or a series of tutorial, because you cannot, especially if you are still studying in electrical diagram, so you cannot approach or you cannot understand the electrical diagram when you mix it all together in analyzing. So first we have to study the power circuit. So we have here, so how to do the power circuit? So first you have to collect your components. So you have to collect the components. So we have the electric motor and we have the thermal relay or thermal overload relay, and we have here the contactor. So this is the contact, the relay contact of the contactor, and we have the circuit breaker, and we have also here the circuit breaker, which is the main supply circuit breaker. And here, this is the circuit breaker for the supply to the motor. So you need to have a circuit breaker. This is for safety. So you need to install the circuit breaker. Also, when you are doing a maintenance, you can switch off. So here I just put here an ammeter so that I can connect to the ammeter on the panel board. So without this, it can be also, if you wire directly here, but for the purpose of simulation, I have to connect this one, this ammeter, so that I can connect with the variable to the panel board. So this panel board here, how to create, this is also another tutorial. So this is another topic. So you can find as well in YouTube how to do this. But I have to focus on the electrical circuit, which is most important in this in the system. So now you have already the component. So you have to wire, you have to arrange the component, motor, the thermal relay, and your contactor, relay contact, your circuit breaker, the CB1. So this is your CB1 and this is your CB2. So you only wire this one. So I put additional here. This is ammeter to connect to the panel board. Because without this, I cannot connect any variable. I cannot put any variable to the ammeter to the panel board. So you just wire, connect the wire, all the wire connect. And then you have to connect the wire to the main supply, and that's it. You have already, and of course you also have here the power supply. So this is coming from the your generator. So now you have the power circuit, motor circuit in this system for the fuel oil supply pump number one. So here, this is a part of the control system. So later on, we will discuss the control system. So I will continue with the power circuit. So later on, we will continue with the control circuit. So here, we have also fuel oil supply pump number 2. So remember that in the ship, in your auxiliary system in the ship, there are always two pairs, or let's say they are couple, or let's say they are husband and wife, shall we say. So what is the purpose? Because the ship need to have a standby auxiliary. So in case the number one is not in service or out of order, so you still have a number two to use. So the ship can still run. The ship, if there is no standby pump, so this is called standby pump. One is service, one is in standby. So if number two in service, number one is standby, and vice versa, number one in service, number two is in standby. So now, because the ship should run continuously without interfering the operation, because the ship without operation, if the ship is not in operation, so it will be going to be up higher, and that is a big loss of money to the owner. So we'll proceed to number 2. So remember, later on, so we have also a booster pump. So remember, the fuel oil supply system is together with the fuel oil booster pump system also. They are working together. So when the fuel oil supply pump, the booster pump is also running. So in other terms also, the booster pump is the circulating pump. So it is a circulating fuel to the injection pump of the engine. So that is the work of the booster pump. But we will discuss that one later on. As I said, this tutorial is going to be a series tutorial. So we cannot, you cannot catch up or approach in one time. So this should be a series of tutorial. So let us come with number two. So fuel oil supply pump number two. So here, so the same as in the fuel oil pump supply pump number one, you have the motor. So you collect the component motor, electric motor, the three-phase electric motor, and then you have the overload relay or the thermal relay or the thermal overload relay, and you have the relay contact of the contactor, which is 3-pole, and you have the 3-pole three poles circuit breaker, and then you have also here the ammeter to connect to the ammeter of the panel board. So again, you have to wire all of them wire. So motor connect to the overload relay, thermal relay, you have to wire connect to the ammeter, and then you have to wire all of this thermal relay to the contactor relay contact, and the contactor relay contact to the circuit breaker, and your circuit breaker you have to wire connect to the main supply. So now you have already your power circuit for the fuel oil supply pump number one and fuel oil supply pump number two. So here your panel board, since this is another set of tutorial, so I will not discuss this one for now, but you can check in YouTube how to do this. There are tutorial there. So I will focus on the electrical circuit, so which is here the power circuit. So in this one here, we have the pressure switch. This is connected to the control circuit, so we will discuss it later. So this is pressure switch number one and pressure switch number two. So this is connected to the control circuit. So now this is your power circuit. So we'll proceed to the control circuit.